got a whole three ring binder? What's happening? What's happening?
No, wait.
What?
Sheriff?
What?
That dude just disappeared. Yo!
Show me the clicker.
Oh. Yo, what?
And welcome to Super G Gaming. What a way to start off a video, man. For some of you that have been following me, I'm formerly known as Gordon Ayers Games, formerly known as Super G, formerly known as Morpheus. I finally came back to my roots, y'all. Mr. Super G, this is me back in the building. So happy and glad to be back to be bringing Alan Wake 2 for you guys. It's been a minute. Hadn't it, guys? It's been a while, but I'm back in the saddle, ready to do my thing for you guys, and I couldn't think of a better game to come back to than Alan Wake 2. I've heard a lot of wonderful things about this game. I've stayed away from any footage, any trailers, any gameplay, because I didn't want to see any of it. I wanted to experience the game for myself firsthand, because you guys know that the way I do things is everything you see, my reactions, everything with the game is always genuine, right? I never play games after I've played them for you guys, because then my responses won't be genuine. So all the jump scares and the screams and all the stuff that I do in the game is live and right there happening as it happens when I'm playing the game. Anyway, guys, I really do hope you enjoy my gameplay of this game. I'm not going to keep you long. Just do me a favor, if this is your first time finding my channel, by all means, I've got tons of gameplay on my channel. By all means, go check it out. But I would absolutely love it if you guys would consider dropping me a subscription. You can also follow me in some of the following. They'll be posted somewhere around here, maybe over there or over there, not quite sure. But if you wouldn't mind following me on some of these platforms and subscribing to me here on my YouTube channel, that'd be great. Last, certainly not least, for those of you that have followed me for a while, check out the new logo. The middle part is the M, Super G. That's me, Mr. Super G. This will be me from now on, guys. No more twitching it up, no more changing anything. This is me. This is how it's gonna be. Anyway, guys, without further ado, let's get back into some more Alan Wake 2. I hope you guys enjoy it. See you there.
To a story with hopes and expectations, looking for an answer. Sometimes it would be better to live with that hope without ever knowing the full story. In a horror story, there are only victims and monsters. And the trick is not to end up as either. But trapped by the genre, we are all ripped to pieces along the way. This is not the story I hoped it would be. This is not the ending I wanted. This story will eat us alive. This story is a monster. Monsters wear many faces.
Oh. you need, man? What you need? Show you what? What? Just like that, we're thrown into the game, man. This is... What? Sir, why are you out here with nothing on? What has happened? What has happened? I don't know if this is the right time to say this, but I mean, the graphics look great. Does that count for something? Holy cow, man. Good gracious. Can you help us? Or help him? Not us, him. What? No. Where you going? Where you going? This is not good. This is not good. I have no clue what's going on. What? Did y'all hear that? Is he hurt? Whoa. Bruh, no, come on, man. I just started playing this game, man. We can't be doing that right now, man. At least let me get my feet back wet again. You know what I mean? Like, for some of y'all that have been following me for a while, man, I've been away. I've missed y'all so much, man. I've really missed doing this for y'all, man. And I'm truly glad and happy to be back, man. I really am. I didn't realize I'm... See, all... Oh, man. Y'all already know, man. Oh! Okay. See? Oh, really? I can't even laugh. I can't even laugh, man. But wait a minute. Why is the horrific face that of Alan Wake though? That's different. I okay, let's just get through here. I can sprint by toggling L3. Are you telling me I need to sprint? Is that tree crying? What is going on? What is actually going on? What am I hearing? What is going on? What am I hearing? Oh no. Wait, what? Well, you remember those guys, but okay, maybe I do need to sprint here. Let's see. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no. This is top speed, y'all. This is all he got. Are we being followed? Oh man, we need the light. We can't get over there. We need that light so bad. Where I have no idea where I'm going. Oh, wait a minute. I don't think they're for me. I think he's holding a knife, y'all. I don't think. Are they coming in? Nope. Oh, I can't go. Oh, wait a minute. What are they shooting at me? Are you kidding? Go, man! Go! Dodge! I'm going back and forth. Hopefully they won't hit me. Oh, there's some light over here. We need some light. Get to the light, man! Get to the light! No! Oh! No! Go, man! You gotta escape. Oh! We gotta escape. Oh, come on, man! Oh, I'm trapped. I'm trapped. There's nowhere I can go. There's nowhere I can go. I'm trapped. No! No! I can't. Why?
I can't.
Why? What's happening? Oh, is he still alive? What? Of the tree! Oh no! 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 I can't look!
Where's the rest of the stuff?
Rest of what stuff? What is you saying?
What the fuck?
What is actually happening? This ain't the Alan Wake I know. Start a game, man. It kind of reminds me of Outlast.
Hey, kiddo.
Outlast has a similar, you know,
good, Mom.
Throw you in the game kind of thing.
This trip might take a little longer than I thought. I'm sorry I've been gone so much lately, Logan.
Oh my God, Mom, it's not your fault. People get all murdery. What happened?
That's cute.
Just work stuff.
Right. Well, Dad and I are just watching the latest episode of Night Springs here. Mom, it's so
not Night Springs.
No spoilers.
That's a throwback.
I'll let you get back to the show. You were supposed to wait and watch.
I wonder if they're going to have any of that in this version.
This is what happens when you go on work trips, Mom. Love you too. And say hi to Casey. Tell him.
Oh, don't say that, man.
So
you'll make your mom feel guilty.
I will. Bye, kiddo. Logan thinks you should try cheering up.
Snarky kid. Wonder where she gets that from.
Awkward silence.
It can't be a coincidence that another body turns up just as we arrive in town. Feels like the killer's leaving us a message.
I'm glad you're on this case with me, Anderson. It's right up your alley. You should take lead. Think of me as the backup.
Okay. Any words of advice?
I love the graphics, man.
Cheer anyone up.
I feel like it has that same that same graphical, grainy, gloomy, like the original Alan Wake.
Time to get to work.
And the graphics are really smooth. Looks good, man.
A deputy was supposed to be here to show us to the crime scene. There's the car, so where's the deputy?
Eaten by a bear?
No.
That map.
Not quite. Returned one invitation. If that deputy was the dude that we trying to find, he
worth memorizing before we get swallowed up by the trees.
Okay, well let's interact with it. The map displays key locations in the area, okay? Uh-oh, did I mash the wrong button? Oh, there we go. Okay, I guess we are here. You know, like those signs you see in a building or the rest stop. You are here. All right, let's keep it going here. Where to? You still staring at the map, man? Should we get going?
I think I hear someone. Could be our deputy.
I can go take a look.
The cup disappeared. Only me would pay attention to something like that.
Hey, over here. Hey there. Agent Casey, right? Sheriff Breaker said you'd be coming by to take over the case.
You're half right. Anderson?
I'm in charge here.
SAGA Anderson. I'll be leading this
SAGA.
Case. Seems you already know my
interesting
partner,
name.
Alex Casey.
Shoot. Sorry about that, ma'am. I'm Deputy Mulligan. I just figured that, you know, that...
Where's those damn feds gonna show up, Mulligan?
Federal agents right here, Thornton.
Yeah.
My partner, Thornton, down at the crime scene. He's not what you call the sharpest axe in the shed.
Yes, we heard you, brother. We heard you. let's get a briefing of what's going on.
What can you tell us about the crime scene?
Tell them about the heart.
I was getting to that, Thornton.
Don't you usually have to, like, press the walkie on that thing?
Organs that are currently outside the victim's person when they should be, but you know, inside.
Man, just speak regular language, man. Any witnesses to the crime?
Were there any witnesses?
Yeah, a couple out of towners. I wonder what they were doing sneaking around the woods at night.
Mention the city folk. It's pretty suspicious.
Not that we have anything against city folk, right, Thornton? But don't worry. Sheriff Breaker took him back to town a while ago.
All right, well, let's take a look at the body.
I want to see the body. How do we get there?
Oh, sure. That's real simple. Just through the hole in the fence, down the hill towards the lake, around the old convenience store. You can't miss it. Everything's been closed since the area was fenced off. The store, the campground, all of it.
Hey, Mulligan, tell them I'm here, winking. I'll show them around.
They got it, Thornton.
Yeah, these graphics are amazing, bro. It looks really, really good. It looks real good.
Before we get to the crime scene, there's time to review
the
facts of the case so far.
Are you kidding me?
Make sure I'm seeing the clues clearly.
Oh, what does it say? You can access the case board inside the mine place, okay?
The mine place. My version of the mine palace technique. To sift through clues and work the case. Building the mine place again for each case. Using each field office as a model in my head. The facts are on the board. Everything we know about the previous murders. Worth taking another look.
The case board is a mental technique that allows SAGA to analyze clues and progress the investigation. You can use the right button to move around. Okay? You can use L2 and R2 to zoom. Thank you very much. Wait a minute. You are now free to navigate the case board or leave by pressing circle, okay? A series of murders have occurred around the town of Bright Falls. Finding the connections will help search for the killer. These are the victims discovered in a shallow grave in 2012. Sorry, guys. State of the body does not match 8 years spent in a lake. You can say typically bloat. Like that chest would have wound was ruled the cause of death. Tattooing on his on the body is ineligible. Murder methods, slight difference in murders, bloating only commonality in the bodies, but not cause of death. Means all of them were in the water. Exposure to water post-mortem, so they put them in the water after they were, you know, killed. Killer profile, talk to someone, okay? Post-mortem tattoo of the body, murder targets have no discernible common traits. Chest trauma resembles animal butchery techniques. Yikes. Okay.
I see you're already hard at work.
Visiting the mine place does not pause the game, so be mindful
started.
Of that. Okay.
Let's head down the hill to the mind. Crime scene.
That's beautiful, man. Wait a minute. If this is the same lake from the original Alan Wake, where is the island that was in the middle?
There's too much sky.
Are you kidding, man? Nature is everything, bro. All right, now you guys know I'm an explorer by nature. So, is there any benefit to exploring this game? Yeah, me personally, man, I love like nature, Casey, like stuff like this.
You're putting me in charge. Why now?
Look, Anderson, you're a better detective than I am. You've cracked cases that had the rest of us baffled. I don't want to slow you down.
Are you thinking of retiring? You know what happens to cops who say this is
their last
case. I
kind of
want to
go up there. Mm-hmm. There's a house up here.
Real funny, Anderson.
What's up here?
I'm going to go check something out. Be right back.
Got it.
Let me guess, because I'm going too early, I can't get in here. Yep. It's a padlock. It's a combination lock on that. Okay. Yeah, it might be a little too soon for me to try to explore. I mean, the game did just start. Yeah, just like with this, I don't think there's nothing I can do up here. Oh, wait a minute. What is this? Bright Falls record, chaos at Cauldron Lake. Oh, Lord, that's a lot to read, guys. That's quite a bit. I'll tell you what, I typically would read this, but I'm not going to do it in this instance. I'm just going to slowly navigate it down so you guys can read it. Pause the video if you need, if you want to read that. Bright Falls' own virtual baking champ. Does a hike a day keep depression away? I would say yes, honestly. Okay. All right, let's get back to the task at hand. I'm so easily distracted, y'all. My bad. Y'all know me. You know how I play, right? I can't help but explore, man. Starting fires is prohibited. Do not feed the wildlife. Leave no trace. You know, it reminds me, man. Anybody remember Smokey the Bear? You remember that guy? I might be dating myself by saying that, but yeah, Smokey was the dude, man. He was the one that would talk about,
stairs,
you know, preventing
you
forest fires.
I'm not that old.
Mirror Peak? Mirror Peak, the mighty mountain in the distance, is no other than Mirror Peak, the iconic landmark overlooking Cauldron Lake. From the right angle, its beauty reflected on the calm surface of the lake, mirrored in all of its inverted glory. It's beautiful, man. I love mountains, man. I love mountains. Let me ask you guys a question. So, between the mountains and the beach, Which one is more appealing to you? Me personally, I like them both, but if I had to choose, I'd probably say the mountains. I don't know why. I just love the mountains. Where does that go? Campgrounds? Man, I want to explore so bad, but I feel like it might be too soon.
Not a bad place to get murdered.
If getting back to nature is your thing.
Because you have a choice to choose where that happens.
Damn. Water. Should have brought an umbrella.
I like the
rain.
Or
is that rain I'm hearing?
The only thing around here that feels like home.
You think the local law had the sense to put up a tarp?
If they did, next coffee's on me.
Oh, man. What y'all know about this right here? Wow. Old school phone booth, boy. I think that's him. General
Hi.
Store.
Deputy Thornton.
Now he waved like Forrest Gump.
That's me, at your service, ready to get this case solved. Now the body's behind the store. Come on, I'll show you.
Okay.
So, FBI, huh?
FBI.
That's so cool. Hunting down psycho serial killers and shootouts with the mob.
You forgot the UFO cover.
I'm sure that's not all they do, what? Man.
Those are real? You guys
No.
Heard?
Oh,
You guys believe in UFOs?
Let's just see this body.
No judgment if you do or don't. I'm just curious if you guys believe in UFOs.
Now this is the scene of the crime.
Oh.
Found him on the table. Now,
great.
We didn't touch nothing, you know. Procedures and stuff.
Thanks, deputy.
No tarp. You owe me a coffee.
Okay. Let's start by examining our guest of honor. Does this fit the MO of the previous murders?
He's not answering.
Step one, examine the corpse.
All right, well, let's get to it.
Body is positioned on the table.
That it is. You unlock your first key image. You can place it on the case board inside the mine place. Okay. Cauldron Lake murder scene.
Another body turns up just as we arrive in town. Coincidence?
I don't think so. Oh, that's dope. Okay, place the key image on the case board begins a new line of investigation. When a key image is placed, it will prompt a new question. Objectives are viewable in the case board. Okay, investigate the crime scene. You're now free to leave. Okay. This is Cauldron Lake murder scene consistent with previous murders? That's a question. Okay. Yeah.
Incised stab wound. Chest cut open. Heart removed. Bruising on the wrist from the cargo straps holding him down. The killer left the heart right next to the body.
Why would they cut it out only to leave it on the table? That doesn't make sense. Okay, heart was removed, but then left on the table near the body. Was this murder interrupted? That's a good point. I didn't think of it like that. Maybe it was interrupted. Bruising indicates victim was alive and restrained, matches other cases. Okay. Major chest trauma. No kidding.
Heart removed from chest, strapped by the wrists. Definitely matches the previous murders.
Mm-hmm.
But this time the heart and the straps were left behind. More clues to work with. This makes four murders that we know about.
The clues have resolved. The clues have resolved the open question and unlocked a deduction. As you advance the investigation, new questions will be unlocked, updating your goals. Okay. You can check updated goals or pressing. Okay. Basically, the crime scene, learn more about the victim, learn more about the killer. Okay.
Who is our victim? Who killed him? Need to find more clues. Large amount of blood on the table.
No kidding.
The victim died here. Multiple people were here. Multiple killers?
Deduction available. Okay, what do we have over here? He's just standing around. You can't help. Well, maybe that's the point. He doesn't want to. You didn't want to interfere with the investigation. Okay, what do we have here?
Someone was drinking beer. They spent time here. Waiting. Someone left in a hurry. Knocked the tripod over. Was this for a camera?
I don't know. Talk to someone. Find evidence. I think we found evidence. Multiple sets of footprints that would go here. Yep. Lots of activity here. It's unlikely our killer was working alone.
Boot prints. Multiple. Indicating multiple killers.
Mm-hmm.
Quite the party.
Multiple assailants present. Messy scene. Crime of passion. Premeditated. For later. Okay. Let's go see if he knows anything. Ah.
Any idea who the victim is?
Oh, I sure do. His name is Nightingale. He was FBI.
Nightingale.
He came to
what,
town
from the
about
first Alan Wake?
13 years ago. Now, I haven't heard a word about him since. Well, until now.
Until now.
Robert Nightingale?
Oh, yes. You probably knew him. Brothers in arms. Oh, and sisters.
Clues will be discovered by speaking to people as well as by examining your surroundings. So you knew the guy?
So you knew our victim.
Well, I didn't recognize him in his current state. But yeah, I ran into him a few times at Quantico. Never worked any cases together. After his partner got killed in the field, he went off the deep end. Got the boot pretty quick after that.
What do you mean he went off the deep end? Let's start with this.
So what happened to Nightingale after the Bureau let him go?
I only know the rumors. Depression led to booze, booze led to paranoia. He got some wild ideas in his head, chased ghosts until he fell off the map. Guess he ended up here.
I bet there's more to that story.
But no happy ending.
Susan's been missing since 2010?
Nightingale went missing 13 years ago, 2010.
The same as all the other victims.
Certainly fits the pattern. Makes me wonder what was going on that year.
Probably something this town wants to forget.
Yeah, I would agree with that too. Okay.
I think that's everything. For now at least.
Mm-hmm. Anything clicking yet?
Not sure. Need to think about it.
Let's hit that case board. Let's see. So the victim. I think we have more pictures here. He went off the deep end, FBI fired. Like, what does that mean exactly, though? I trust Casey's read on people sounds like our victim wasn't mentally stable. Victim is Robert Nightingale. He don't look anything like that now. That guy looked, he didn't look anything like this. Last seen Bright Falls 13 years ago.
Robert Nightingale, ex-FBI, came to Bright Falls 13 years ago.
Let's put these pictures out. Let's put it over here. Looks new, brought by the killers. Why? To mount a camera, weird stuff and snuff film?
They planned for the murder to happen here, passing the time with equipment ready. They were waiting for him. But why Nightingale? He's been missing for 13 years. Why here? Why now?
I don't know. Victim came front.
Profiling. Get into the subject's head. See what they saw. Feel what they felt. Use whatever I know about them to guide my intuition to a revelation. Piece it together.
Profiling. You can use profiling inside Saga's mind, mind place to get inside the victims, inside the heads of the suspects and victims. Okay. Wait, there's something over here. What is this?
This mug always cheers me up.
Not the worst, Mom. Okay, profiling. Using her intuition, Saga can discover new clues by profiling people of interest. Let's start with missing person.
Agent Nightingale has been MIA for 13 years. How did he end up here?
Up from the lake that's not a lake. It's dark. He was there too. You are not allowed in the lake until he says otherwise.
Robert Nightingale came from the lake before his murder.
But okay, let me keep going.
Nightingale was chosen as the victim. Why?
Flick the switch. It goes click. Lights are off. But somebody's home. Somebody's home.
This wasn't some random act of violence. This was a ritual. And Nightingale a component. They didn't see him as a person. More like a container for something.
I always like envy, you know, the minds of detectives and how they're able to like piece stuff like this together. Like you have to really have a mind to be able to like navigate through that stuff to piece together, you know, a comprehensive, you know, deduction at the end. I've always admired that. Okay. Was that it? Was I done? Is there more to it? Oh yeah, we got that yellow. Okay. Because I'm noticing, like, when you complete a segment of the case study, it turns that index card from yellow to green. So this one is yellow. So it means there's more to it. Okay, and it's right here. Nightingale came from Cauldron Lake. I can feel the Nightingale came. But now he's with 13. Where has he been? Check the lake shore. It's still yellow, though. Am I forgetting something?
The lake is connected to Nightingale somehow. Casey, let's take a look down by the lake. Lead the way.
Sounds good. This way, right?
Right.
Okay. Well, I'll just wait here.
Yeah, you do that. Guard the body, please, if you wouldn't mind. Make sure the killers don't come back and try to obtain it.
This one of your hunches, Anderson? Did something happen at the lake?
I think Nightingale came up from that direction. From the lake. Probably looking for shelter. Safety. They were waiting for him.
When you're ready, I'd love to hear what you put together so far.
Sure. It's not that complicated. Nightingale was out in the woods alone at night, possibly nude. The killers knew he was here, ambushed him, dragged him to the campgrounds, strapped him to the table, cut his heart out. But then they were interrupted by those witnesses, the Bookers.
What's this?
The job is unfinished.
That seems pretty complicated to me. What was this guy doing skinny dipping at this time of year?
I haven't figured that part out yet.
Mm-hmm. Lots of
questions. What is this up here?
Lots of answers for us to find.
I know I shouldn't be up here. I can't help it, guys. I can't help it. I saw something shiny. It's open. There's nothing in here. Well, at least right now. Is that sunlight refracting off the ground? Okay, let me go back, man. I'll be getting so easily distracted, y'all. Let me go back. Sorry, Casey. I'm back on the job, man. I promise. Okay. Let's keep going. Witch's ladle? That's some interesting.
I didn't know trees got that big.
Yo, golly, that's like more. What they call those sequoia kind of trees. Okay. What have we here? Examine the blocked path.
There's a piece of paper on the ground.
It's got that visual glitch like in the first Alan Wake.
Tracks. Barefoot. Nightingales? They come out from under the boulder.
It makes no sense.
Okay, I don't think there's anything else I can interact with here.
A page full of text on one side. Not a printout. Written with a typewriter. Old school. Lines scratched out and edits added with a pen.
Mm-hmm, like a manuscript. Page of a story.
Oh, here we go. That was Alan Wake's thing.
Message.
It's for us. The text is about us. The victim was one of their own. FBI Special Agent Robert Nightingale. And then there was the page they found. The first step down into terrifying depths.
Terrifying depths?
These words felt like a message.
Felt like a message.
Someone knew they were here. Someone playing a game with them. An invitation. How could they not accept?
Even if they knew it would end up hurting them.
Knew it would end up hurting them?
Someone's been watching us.
Playing a sick game with us.
You were right. This is right up my alley. Nightingale came this way. Either he dropped this page, or the killers left it for us.
Profiling, okay.
I should profile Nightingale about this page.
I need to go back. Wait a minute. Manuscript pages. What is this? And what is that? The Certificate of Materius case. Achievement to Agent one. Saga Anderson. Cool job. Cool beans. Manuscript pages. Okay, we've got one profile. Oh, that's easier to just use. Okay, all right. The page.
We found a page in the woods. A story about these events. What is Nightingale's role in this?
I carry his words close to my chest now. Inside, the awful truth. You must dig it out.
Something was put inside him, in his chest. I must find out what.
And I guess for me, the more important question is why? Are y'all not gonna talk? Did I miss something? Typically, if they don't communicate, I feel like that means I've missed something. See? Okay. Footprints emerging from under the rock. What? He walked through a boulder. Doesn't make sense. Trail has gone cold.
I think he came from the lake. But his tracks make no sense.
Too many unknowns. Doesn't make sense in asking the wrong questions. Oh, we got more. Okay, anything else here? Let's come down here. There's more going on here than I'm seeing. I need to examine his body properly back in town.
Huh. Found all I can here. Time to properly examine the body. See what I can find inside.
Okay.
Casey, I think something's been put inside Nightingale's body. Let's tell the deputies to get the body to the town morgue.
Okay.
Set. Okay.
Whoever wrote that page made sure it read like a story. Like a scene from a thriller.
I hate all of it. The text said we'd find more. I believe it.
But what's the
purpose?
That's
not the part I'm concerned about.
They're twisting events to create their own narrative to do what? Entertain some fantasy? Projecting their desires? Are we characters or the audience? Witnesses to their design?
All valid questions.
All the above?
It's all about control. Deciding what happens to who. Don't let it drag you in.
Too late. I'm already hooked. I need the next chapter.
I'm more concerned about what was said at the end about even though it knew it was going to hurt them. That's the part I'm trying to figure out. Because I don't think they know that. We don't know that. And hurt them how? Like, in what way?
Made it back. Good. I hope you didn't get stuck in any of those big puddles. Crazy.
Man, what?
Down there, huh? Just like I said.
He's an interesting guy, man.
Deputy, I want the body taken back to town for a proper examination, ASAP.
Well, sure. But the coroner won't be back in town for another week after Deerfest.
Not a problem. I'll do it myself.
Oh, and Sheriff Breaker called to say he's got the bookers at the O'Deer Diner in town. Oh, and I've got a key to the gate. It's a shortcut back to the parking lot just up the hill.
Thanks, man. Let me hold that.
Thanks.
All right. Okay, take the car back to Bright Falls.
Let's get the car. Drive to Bright Falls and talk to these witnesses, the bookers.
At the diner, right? I could use a cup of coffee.
Let's try that shortcut the deputy mentioned.
Sounds good.
Yeah, makes sense to me. I'm sorry, did she actually put the key in the lock?
I didn't see that. Murders aside, pretty woods. Cute lodge we got set up in. We should go for a hike if we get a chance.
Now you're just being mean, Anderson.
Deputies aren't exactly up to the task, but hopefully the sheriff will be more helpful.
Not a surprise about the deputies. Doubt they see much stuff this gruesome.
I would agree. This is a. I would love to like hike a place like this, if not for anything, just for the scenery alone. Man, this place is beautiful, and it's just a game. What have we here? Some type of communications array? Is this accessible? I'm guessing no.
I think nope. I saw something.
Wait, it'll what's this over here?
I'll wait here.
What have we here?
Is that
a toboggan?
Kid's lunchbox?
Are these eggs? Is that supposed to signify an Easter egg? What is this?
An Alex Casey movie lunchbox. Casey hates the endless jokes about coincidentally having the same name as a fake detective. He hates those cheesy crime books. But he really hates the movies.
I bet you do. Manuscript fragments. We are here. We are all in this. We're all in this together. Hero, have a heroic day. Okay. Manuscript fragments can be used to upgrade weapons. Pistols. Again and again, hold the fire button to activate auto fire mode. This significantly increases the rate of fire, increases magazine size. Land 2 headshots in quick succession to stun an enemy for extended duration. Oh man, we don't have nowhere near. We only got 2 pieces. We ain't got nowhere near enough. Okay. All right. Let's head back. Sorry, brother. Shiny objects. Can't help it. Shiny objects. All right, I'm back. Casey Jones from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Can't fit the clues all together yet. Heart removed. Tripod. Tracks leading to a dead end.
A tripod for a camera? To record a snuff film?
Maybe. And why take out his heart just to throw it away?
To stuff in something for us to find.
Yeah, but you couldn't have done that some other way? Like, did you have to do that exactly? You know, you could have just put it in his hand or his mouth. Cauldron Lake. Wait, which way do we go? Lead the way, Casey. I keep saying it, man, but the game looks amazing. It looks amazing. And it's very similar to the original Alan Wake.
Let's drive back to town and meet the sheriff. Graphics.
Wait, where are you going, man? Oh, okay. I want to say we didn't drive that car, we drove this one. All right, let's head back.
I can't get that manuscript page out of my head. I've never seen killers reach out so directly before.
I don't think it was the killers.
Work so far. With your technique, these hunches were moving fast.
I wasn't sure about taking a case so far from home, but I'm thrilled to be here for this mystery.
I get that. I absolutely get that.
Need to swing by the lodge to get anything from the field office?
No, I'm all set.
I'll park there anyway. I want to walk to the diner, get a feel for the town.
Bright Falls. Hadn't changed a whole lot, just older. Not the people dance at the human advertisement people.
The diner's just up the waterfront. Shouldn't keep the sheriff and our witnesses waiting.
I smell coffee.
I'm sure you do, Casey. All right, guys. Well, I think this is where I'm going to take my first break of this game, man. I'm really enjoying it so far. I feel like we got a lot of game to cover here, which I will be doing. And thank you guys for all of your support. I want to take this quick moment to just say thank you for all of you that have been reaching out to me on Twitter, those of you that have been responding to my YouTube, those of you that have been trying to follow me in different social media avenues, man, I really appreciate all of you very, very much. It's because of you guys that I'm back. I've missed it. I've missed doing this with you guys. I've missed interacting with you guys. And I'm back to do what I've, you know, I've grown to love. So you guys just stick with me, man. We're going to get through this game and many, many more games in the future. You guys take it easy. Stay blessed. I will be back real soon with more Alan Wake 2, guys. Don't forget to subscribe also. I don't want to not forget to say that. Don't forget to subscribe below, guys. I really appreciate your support continually, especially if you're new to the channel. But I'll see you guys again soon. Later.